What's up, everybody? I don't know why I did that. I feel great today because I have such a valuable tip. I almost didn't want to share it. It's so valuable, but I thought, you know what? So many people are asking me, I gotta answer it. So the question is, how do you take a photo that you took and shrink it down, resize it, make it small, but still maintain excellent quality to upload to social media? So many people have that question. I don't know what it is. But today, I'm gonna give you that answer. So let's jump into Photoshop and get right to it. All right, guys, so as you can see, I have this portrait of this boxer that I took for a film I was working on. And what I'm gonna do is, if you have all these layers over here, if they're open, basically condense all those layers. So you're gonna go up here to layer, and then you're gonna go all the way down to flatten image. Okay, then you're gonna press okay. And then you're gonna have all your layers condensed. Next, what you're gonna do is go to image, and then to image size. You could also press option or alt, hold that down along with the command key simultaneously, and press I, okay? And when you do so, you'll get this box, image box up here. And in this image box, what you're gonna do is, we wanna change the pixels, okay? So with Facebook, social media, Google Plus, all of these social medias, the width is always gonna be this. It's gonna be 20 by 48, okay? Basically, I researched and I figured out what's the width that they condensed all their images to, and the width is 20 by 48. Don't ask me why, I know it's a totally random number, but for whatever reason, that's the number they chose, so that's what we're gonna use. All right, so that's gonna play nice with all our social media. So up here where it says pixels, we got 2048. This is obviously connected, so this will change, the height will change automatically. Make sure you have all these checked. I forgot to say that, but make sure you have all of them checked. Also, now we're gonna go down. This is really key. Now you could go, since you're making it smaller, most likely, you could go to bicubic sharper. However, we want to sharpen our own images, right? We don't want Photoshop to do it. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to bicubic smoother. All right, and then we're going to press OK. Now we have our image in the right size. So we just resized our image, but we're not done yet because we still have to sharpen it, and then we have to save it the correct way. So we still have a few steps left. So what we're going to do now that we have it in the right size, and if you want to check it, again, you can just press Option Alt Command I, and then you can see the dimensions right there, okay? All right, so next what we're gonna do, we're gonna go to Background Layer, and we're gonna double click on that, and what we're gonna do is press Duplicate Layer, and you're gonna see a little background copy. We're gonna click on that, and then you're gonna have a copy of your layer right here. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go up to the top, we're gonna go to Filter, we're gonna go down to sharpen. We're going to go over to unsharp mask. So it's right over here. We're gonna click on that. And then once the unsharp mask comes up, you're gonna see something that says 100%, and basically that's all zoomed in. And it's gonna show you sort of what it looks like if you sharpen it. Now, as a reference point, I usually do something between like 0.7 to about 0.8 or 0.9, okay? You can move this and obviously it changes, but then threshold, you can change that. But I'm gonna keep the threshold at 3, okay? The radius, I'm gonna usually put it at 0.7 or 0.8, all right? I'm gonna leave it at 0.7 for now, and then leave the amount at 100%. And then we're gonna just click okay. All right, then we're gonna have to click a layer mask. So what we got to do is we have to go over here on the background copy. We're going to go down and see this little layer down here with a little circle in it. We're going to click on that, and we're basically creating a layer mask. Now what we're going to do is, now that you have this highlighted, you're going to press Command I. So when you press Command I, that's Command Inverse. All right. And then we're gonna have to go over here to our brush tool. So one, make sure this is white and black, okay? We want the white brush. So you could just click on this. If it was on black, you just click over in this little thing right here, toggle it off to make sure it's on white. And then you're going to press the letter B. And once you press the letter B, it's going to go to the brush tool, which is right here. Okay, so now we have our brush tool. What you can do is you can press the bracket key, which is next to the P key on most computers, all right? It's in the upper right-hand corner, most computers. And the left bracket key will make it smaller, your brush, and the right bracket key will make your brush larger. Okay, so what we're gonna do now, we're gonna have to zoom in, and the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go up here to our opacity. Make sure your opacity is at 100%. Make sure your flow is at 100%. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna go in, we're gonna make sure we're zoomed in, and we're just gonna sharpen the areas we wanna sharpen to 100%. So for me, for portraits, it's usually the eyes. So I'm gonna get right in here. Maybe it's a little small, in between right there. And I'm gonna make sure I get all of the eye. So I'm gonna sharpen that nice and thoroughly. All right, right there. Right there to an extent. All right, so now if we back up, we can see, it might be tough to see on this, but you see the difference right there? It's just very subtle, but we're adding sharpness to the eye. So we just added it to the eye, now it's a little sharper. Now we wanna add some sharpness to the face. Now we don't wanna add it to the whiskers, because when you add it to the beard or some person, I said whiskers, not a cat, but if you add it to a person's face, right? You don't want to add too much because it will look funny. So that's what I've known from experience doing this a lot. So I'm going to put the opacity down to about 70%. And then I'm going to make my brush bigger and I'm going to keep going. I'm going to back up. Now it's all how much you want to sharpen. All right. But I'm going to show you how we change that later on. So don't worry about overdoing it too much right now. Don't stress out. We just want to get it nice and sharp for the most part. All right, his face, because that's where I want the person's eye to go. And I also kind of want to go to the glove, because the glove is important right here. We want to make it like stick out, make it a little more three-dimensional. And you can see right over here where we've sharpened. It shows it in the little layer mask right there. So we're sharpening the glove. All right, sharpening it nice. Maybe the glove will give you more. Maybe let's do the glove at 100%, right? We want to really make it pop out, especially right here in this region. We can zoom in if we have to, all right? And you can see before and after. Subtle, but it makes a difference, all right? It makes it a little pop out, a little sharper, all right? Now we're just going to go over, and then I usually go down to about 50%. And this is just for my general sharpening. So I want to sharpen his face, just overall, just a quick sharpen, and his head. All right, ears, all right. Not really going to do the body, because the body, I don't really want to focus. Mainly the gloves and the face, because that's where the focus should be. All right, I use a shallow depth of field, which is why this glove isn't that in focus, but it's okay. All right, so now our image is much sharper, on, off, all right? It's very subtle, but you can see it, all right? This is the nuance that really makes your photo that much better. On, then off. Now, let's say you sharpened it too much. You can go over here to the opacity, and you can bring it down. Now, I recommend somewhere I found between about 55% and about 70%. In that range, if you sharpened it way too much, you might want to go down to 55%. And if you haven't sharpened it enough, you can go up to 70%. Let's leave it at 70%. So still going to be sharp, but it's not going to be ridiculous. Remember, we don't want to sharpen too much. You can see his beard being sharpened right there, but we don't want it too much, right? 70% is good. All right, so you can adjust it accordingly to how you want it. All right, so now that I have that all sharpened the way I want, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to save it. So the way we save it is we're going to go up here to File. Then we're going to go down to save for web. All right, not save as or save. We're going to go to save for web, which is all these key commands combined. But I usually just click on this. All right, so now this is going to pop up. So now how are we going to save it? So we're going to save it as a JPEG, all right, up here. Make sure, all right, so this is where, make sure this is clicked. You want it optimized and you want to embed color profile. That basically means it's going to have the same colors that you intended to use. What you see on your computer screen is what you want to see. So I go over here and I make sure I have monitor color because I know my screen is calibrated for the right color composition. So that's what I'm going to use. All right, so then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to quality. Now, I already have it at the percentage I want. It might be at 100%, okay? Over here in the left-hand corner, you can see how big the file is going to be. Now, I've found that Google+, Facebook, Instagram, all these social media sites, they compress the photos. So if you take a really large photo, you may say, oh, I'm getting away with it. It'll look better on Facebook. Well, that's not the case because Facebook uses their own compressor and they actually make a really large file look worse. So instead, what we want to do is we want to make it as big as we can, but not too big that Facebook will actually adjust the quality of it. So what we do, I found that range to be between about 65% all the way to about 75. So you can experiment, but I found within 65 to 75 is where I've played around with it to be the optimal quality. So that's why I leave it right about 70%, right in the middle right there. That's where you're gonna get the best quality, and Facebook is not gonna mess with your image. When someone clicks on it, it's still gonna retain the quality. So then you're gonna go to the width right there. We already adjusted it, so we don't have to mess with that. Remember here, change it to bicubic smoother. It's at 100%, we're all good to go. Over here, we can see how small the file is. Super easy to click on and see. Yeah, look at the quality, look how good the quality is. Still, you can see it large on my screen and we maintain all the quality. So then we press save. All right, so now I know I'm gonna save it here. You can just label whatever you wanna call it. Then you press save and that's it, you're done. That's how you resize and sharpen an image in Photoshop so that you can upload it to social media without any quality being lost. All right guys, so now you can see the finished photo here, nice and big. Although we resize it so the file size is super small, yet the resolution and quality remains the same because we sharpened it and resized it properly, and that's how you do it. All right guys, I know that video was straight gold, so you gotta press that like button. You gotta add a comment, all right? I didn't even wanna release it, but I thought so many people have been asking, I had to do so. So I hope you found it helpful. It'll change your world. All your photos now will be sharp, and when you upload them, you'll be like, yes, I no longer have to downgrade the quality when I upload to social media. Get your social media game on point. And also, if you haven't done so, subscribe to my channel so you can get more videos like this. And I just made a photo gear guide with all my favorite gear. I give examples, descriptions, etc. You can download that here for free. And you can get more videos like this over here. And I will see you in the next video.